On the 31st of July after breakfast, we proceeded to visit Numa Valley and So Moriri Lake. The road journey to Numa was excellently beautiful with colored mountains on the left side of our road and patches of green pastures. We stayed in one of our friend's house in Numa. Next day, in the morning, we had our breakfast in our friend's house and then proceeded to So Moriri. The pristine blue, So Moriri Lake in Changthing region of Ladakh is one of the most beautiful, calm, and sacred, high-altitude lakes in India. This lake is about 7 km wide at its broadest point and about 19 km long. Then we returned to our hotel Siala guest house in Leh. We went to the market and had our dinner. We had reached almost the end of the trip. On the 2nd of August, we stayed in Leh and visited the important spots here. Our first stop was Spituk Gompa, situated on a hilltop, and commanding a beautiful view of the city. It was established in 11th century AD. The museum here has a rich collection of ancient masks, antique arms and numerous Thanka paintings. Further up on the hill is an old Kali temple. Our next stop was Leh Palace. The palace is 9 stories high. In the past, the upper floors accommodated the royal family, while the stables and storerooms were located on the lower floors. The entire city of Leh is visible from the top. Namgyal Seymour Monastery near the Leh Palace was our next halt. The monastery is renowned for its three-story high solid gold idol of Maitreya Buddha. Situated on a mountain top behind the Leh Palace, the monastery offers panoramic views of the surrounding countryside, the gently flowing Indus River, and the snow-capped peaks of Zanskar Range. Our last stop was Shanti Stupa, which is a Buddhist white dome stupa on a hilltop in Chanspa, Leh. It was built in 1991 by Japanese Buddhist bhikshu, Gyomyo Nakamura, and part of the Peace Pagoda Mission. It holds the relics of the Buddha at its base, enshrined by the 14th Dalai Lama. The stupa has become a tourist attraction not only due to its religious significance, but also due to its location, which provides panoramic views of the surrounding landscape. Bidding goodbye to this beautiful landscape, we left the Siala guest house early in the morning to board our flight back to Delhi.